Hello, Teleostris once more tonight. Tonight is the second gun. My muzzle loaders, anyway. My CBA Squirrel Rifle. 32 caliber, made in 19... My dad built this one also for me, but this one was 1983. Another sentimental one, although a very frustrating one at first. She's 32 caliber, as you can see, she's a bit worn. She's got some wear marks. Again, percussion lock. Double trigger. This makes it a hair trigger, which of course I don't want to. But yeah, when I actually damaged the nipple on this. Got fully adjustable sights, and I'm hoping you can see there is, you know, wear on the bluing, and some of it's actually starting to turn to like a brownish blue patina. Again, this barrel was made in Spain. I think it's Jucar barrel, which actually have a good reputation. And this one has an aluminum ramrod. I actually had to replace the original tip. And actually, this is pretty much the only gun where I actually use the ramrod. Everything else I use a metal range rod. And which most of the time is a Brown Betts ramrod, a spare one that I got. But what's interesting about this one is this is a 32 caliber rifle. The bore, though, was so tight that I found that a lot of 32 caliber jags and everything actually were too tight of a fit. Like, it was very hard to clean and to load her. Until I, luckily a friend I knew online helped me out and was able to bring a jag down to a 28 caliber bore, and then she fits no problem. Very cheap gun to shoot, 32 calibers, they're like the 40 grain bullets. You know, I actually bought a whole bunch of buckshot, and I used that. And she's pretty good with accuracy. I like to bring her out every once in a while. This one is, of course, a half stock, rather than a full stock, as my Kentucky rifle is. And that's typical of, like, the Eastern short Hawkins-style gun. You know, they did have the Hawkins, they also did have the half-stock style, maybe like more like a Vincent rifle. But, she's old. You can see some of the verdigris here, green, you know, aging. And the key. And she's got a little bits of dings. I try to maintain these as much as I can. Because like I said, these are lifetime. You know, I intend to have this gun when I'm an old fart. So... very, very nice gun. Funny thing is, my dad thought he would be like, I would be like him and be into like carbines and small caliber and everything, and until he realized that, no, I'm actually into big military smoothbores. But he just laughed about that, and he was like, well, you know, because in World War II, he actually was, the M1 carbine was his gun, because he was a combat engineer. 503rd Light Pontoon. And, I gotta tell you, these were handy little guns in their time. Cheap as all hell. And the kits were cheap, but you know what? They're fun shooters. And it's a shame CBA doesn't make these anymore, because really, it is such a shame, because these traditional side locks are just perfect starter guns. They really are. But I just had to show this one, too. A lot of sentimental value. Not as much as my Kentucky rifle, but still. I love Squirrely. Yeah, that's the name of this one. Okay, well, enough of my rambling. Have a good one. Keep your powder dry.